許してもらいます。これでは。
So what I'm showing here is actually a little small printer that we built for use on P1 SSRL. So this is the printhead. This
SRL. And so this panel has been a very collaborative work. I want to thank some of the collaborators, especially. So I want to thank Chris DeSoni, who's also a staff scientist here at Slack, and his group, especially Costa. Who is another staff scientist here at Slack, who have been working with a lot on these peroxide materials and solar cell devices that you make from them. And then Mike Tony and his group, and especially Ari Goldberger, who have also worked with a lot on the material that I've talked about here today. So, thank you for paying attention. I hope this has been enjoyable and educational, and I'm happy to take care of
you. Before you ask questions, 3231
Okay.
We're here on Earth. This is a satellite. This in particular, this graph is made by the WMAP science team. WMAP is a satellite. That's our satellite. Satellites like this, cameras on Earth, are observing our universe. And if we keep going back in time, we cross the various phases of development of the universe. Okay, so any slice through here is a slice in time of how things lived in the universe at that point in time. Just to know you, the acceleration is going up. Okay, so that's actually a problem in itself. The accelerated expansion of the universe. The regular expansion that happened over time is when galaxies and planets and structures of clusters of galaxies and so forth formed. And if you go back far enough in time, you eventually come to the point about 400 million years after the start of the universe when stars were first switching on. Right before then, it was dark. There was nothing there. Or there was stuff there, it was glowing. Stars haven't turned on yet. And if you go back even further, you get to a point 280,000 years after the start of the universe. And this is the glow of the Big Bang. The afterglow of the Big Bang is caused by the remember. Same thing when they're looking at us, they're seeing us as we were 4 billion years ago. Let's keep pushing this. Up front of the field. So this is one of the most sensitive optical images ever taken. This was done by the Hubble Space Telescope, pointing to a part of the sky that looked dark, but there was nothing there. And it's a very small part of the sky. It's actually smaller than the full moon in the sky. So it's about a tenth of the size of the full moon in the sky. They added all these images together, and they got 10,000 galaxies. Okay, so assuming blank space, blank area of the sky, interior of the sky, and there are 10,000 galaxies in there, and the light from these objects is 13 billion years old. Okay. So, can we see all the way to the beginning?